I would like to give you some examples as application on the dynamic and energy equation as well. The first example is siphoning water through a pipe, 10 centimeter diameter as shown, neglect friction, determine the discharge through the siphon and the minimum pressure in the pipe. You know, this siphoning, you can sometime use it when you try to get some gasoline from your car to give it to somebody who's running out of gas. So you try to have the pipe a little bit below the tank or below the free surface in the tank. So this case, point B is below the free surface with 5 meters. The point A, the beginning of the siphon, is 1 meter below the free surface. So point one here would have pressure, rho g multiplied by this 1 meter, would also have potential, which is 4 meter here, 5 minus 1, okay? So if we can think about Z1 plus P1 over G as the piezometric head. The piezometric head here, in this case, is 5 meters. The piezometric head here is 5 meters, which is Z1 plus P1 over rho G. Okay, Z1 is 4 meter, and P1 over rho G is 1 meter, so this is 5 meters. That's equal V squared B divided by 2G, you can get VB here to be about 9.9 meter per second. And then we can move on, get the area of the pipe cross-section, pi d squared over 4, multiplied by VB, you get the discharge, or sometimes called volume flow rate, about 0.078 meter cubed per second. And that means about 78 liters per second. Okay, look at the pipe and tell me now where is the point of the minimum pressure. I think point C here has the highest potential energy and it has the same kinetic energy as B, or as all the pipe, the same velocity, the same cross-section area. So probably point C would have the minimum pressure since it has the largest potential, okay? So point C has the minimum pressure. We again write down Bernoulli equation between 1 and C to get the pressure at C, negative 6.5 multiplied by rho G, or -63,765 Pascal negative, means vacuum, means below the atmospheric pressure. As we said before, the gauge pressure can be positive or negative. If the pressure is below the atmosphere, it would be negative. If the pressure is above the atmosphere, it would be positive. But there's no meaning for negative absolute pressure, for example. But this is a gauge pressure negative at sea, as you can see. This is the minimum pressure point. Again, we have here another nice example, sudden expansion pipe. A pipe, circular pipe, that suddenly expanded from area 1 to area 2. And for sure, V2 would be less than V1 because we have incompressible flow. We can apply mass conservation, A1 V1 equal A2 V2. What do we need here? We would like to evaluate the head loss in the shown sudden expansion. I'm sorry, this is head, not heel. I'm sorry, there's a D here. Please notice. Then the loss can be evaluated from something like energy equation. And I cannot say Bernoulli, because actually we have losses. That means we have eddies, we have rotation, we cannot apply Bernoulli equation, but we say the energy at the departure station equal the energy at the arrival station plus some losses. You spend the sum of these losses in the way from station one to station two. Okay, station one and two, after the streamline became straight, and we start to have almost uniform flow in the pipe. Okay, now we would like to get a relation between the pressure and the velocities here. We use a momentum equation, assuming no shear, so there's no force parallel to the wall, no shear stress. So we apply momentum equation, the external forces come in the right-hand side, P1, A2. This is a little bit strange. Why we used A2 for P1? Yes, because of these eddies, the pressure at P1 is actually also applied here. These vortices make the pressure here dominant, the pressure P1 dominant in this area. So as if we have all this area, which is A2, with the pressure P1. So minus P1, A2, always the pressure into the surface and normal to the surface, into the fluid. The pressure P2 is in the opposite direction. We have minus P2, A2, equal minus rho A1, B1 squared. That's the inlet flux of momentum. We get the exit flux of momentum. Again, we use the momentum equation that A1, V1 equal A2, V2. And then we get P1 minus P2 divided by rho equal V2 squared minus V1, V2. Okay? Now, we substitute here to get the H losses in this form. And some algebra here, and using the mass conservation, the H losses would be V1 squared divided by 2G multiplied by 1 minus area 1 divided by area 2, all square. I would like here to comment, if area 1 equals area 2, then this bracket would be 0, and accordingly no losses, because there's no change in area and there's no change in velocity, as there's no vortices. But if area 1 is very small compared to area 2, as a pipe going into the tank, so the area 1 be small, area 2 would be large, then in this case, this tends to 0, and the losses will be V1 squared over 2G. In other words, all the kinetic energy of the flow coming in will be lost at the sharp entrance here, at the sharp entrance. You can reduce this K if you have here streamlined, and then this K can be reduced maybe to 0.2 or 0.1, depending how smooth you get your connection between the pipe and the tank, okay? You will know this is called minor losses for pipe connection. Major losses will be along the pipe, and it will be according to the so-called Darcy-Weisbach relation, that the H losses will be friction coefficient multiplied by length divided by diameter multiplied by V squared over 2IG. V is the average speed, which is Q divided by area. I'm sure Dr. Ibrahim Shaheen would explain this to you and will tell you how to evaluate the friction coefficient using Moody diagram. A relation between friction coefficient, Reynolds number, and the roughness of the pipe, as you will see soon. Okay? Now, I would like to give another example here on the moment of momentum conservation equation. Moment of momentum conservation equation, capital B, will be R cos V multiplied by M, and the small b will be R cos V. Please note the order, because R cos V is equal negative V cos R. So try to be consistent. Well, we have an impeller here. The outer diameter of the impeller is 40 centimeters. Huh? This is the outer diameter, 40 centimeter diameter. The inner diameter would be 20 at inlet. The flow always from inlet to outlet, outward from smaller radii to larger radii. And then we can calculate the moment of momentum out minus the moment of momentum in, and the difference would be equal to the torque on the fluid. You reverse the sign, you get the torque on the impeller, okay? I would like you to look at the side view here. Here is the blade, flow coming in here, leaving like this, coming in here, leaving like this. The width here is B, so if we'd like to calculate mass flow rate, we can calculate the side area multiplied by the radial speed VR, which is this component here. You get the discharge multiplied by rho, you get the mass flow rate, and so on. Definitions, the angle between the relative speed, which is tangent to the blade, and tangent to the blade at this point, is the blade angle, beta. The angle between the absolute velocity, V absolute, and the tangent is called the flow angle, alpha. Flow angle between the absolute velocity and the tangent. Blade angle between the relative speed and the tangent, okay? And we do this at inlet as we do it at outlet, okay? Then we multiply here the moment of momentum equation to get the torque. Here's the mass flow rate, pi d2 b2, this surface area, side area, multiplied by vr, get mass flow rate, multiplied by rho. I'm sorry, get the discharge, get mass flow rate here. It came to be 286.5 kilogram per second. The impeller rotates at 720 RPM, like an eight-pole motor running this impeller, okay? We get omega, which is RPM, but multiplied by 2 pi, twice pi, divided by 60, came to be 75.4 radians per second, okay? Now, the moment of momentum here, well, at inlet, here is the relative speed. Here is the relative speed at inlet, and we add to it the metal speed U1 pi D1 RPM divided by 60 or omega R1, and then you get the absolute. It's the optimum case to get the absolute radial. There's no absolute tangential here. So actually this gives you zero because you actually multiply V absolute cross product my R, and the sine angle between them is zero, okay? So get zero here. At exit, we have M dot R2 V theta 2. V theta 2, this is V relative. You add it U, you get V absolute. You can analyze V absolute in the radial direction. VR gives no torque, and V theta or V world, this part here, okay? Accordingly, we calculate the torque. This is the torque of the moment. And multiply the moment by omega, you get the power. Okay? Notice that V theta 1 is 0, absolute for sure. V theta 2 is not 0. Okay? Now, this torque on the fluid is in the same direction as the rotation of the impeller, or this torque on the turbine will be in the same direction as the direction of rotation. And this means it is positive work. So it's a negative work, it's a pump. It's a pump. The torque on the fluid, torque on the fluid in the same direction as the rotation. The torque on the impeller in the opposite direction of rotation. So it is a pump, okay? We calculate the power. We calculate the power. Where is it? Where we are? Torque, omega, you get the power. 36.6 kilowatt, okay? We would like to calculate here the drag force for the boundary layer, flow over a plate. The flow is coming uniform with velocity capital U, but leaving as a variable here. Why? Because of the real fluid has real viscosity. We have zero velocity here, and the velocity is increasing. For example, we cannot apply here Bernoulli equation because we have real fluid. We don't have ideal fluid. So we would like to calculate the drag force. Actually, the drag is the integration of shear stress tau versus area here. But anyway, we calculate the momentum in, calculate the momentum out. The momentum out is less than momentum in, and the difference equals the force applied on the fluid by the plate. By the plate. Again, we apply the mass conservation. dm by dt is zero here, the left-hand side. Here we have this streamline intersect this inlet section at a distance equal delta star here. This is delta star. So the actual flow that goes here into the stream tube, this will be O U delta minus delta star. Mass coming in negative. Here mass leaving out positive. But we have to integrate here because the mass, the velocity is variable. The velocity is zero at the wall. The velocity is maximum at the edge of the boundary layer, where du by dy is also zero here. And u at y with semi delta equal capital U. Okay? Accordingly, we get delta star here as if we consider the plate to reduce the inlet area by delta star. So then the flow coming in with uniform speed here equal the flow leaving out with variable speed here. Because this is streamline, no flow crosses the streamline and no flow also crosses the wall. And that's why we get displacement thickness delta star. Apply momentum equation, we get momentum thickness. Again, this has a ratio of length and whether delta star or theta. And we apply the momentum equation, F equal minus O U square, delta minus delta star. The velocity here is uniform, capital U, but the velocity is variable. We integrate to U squared UI from Y equals U to Y equal delta. And then we go ahead and again, we can see F equal rho U squared theta. Theta is a momentum thickness. Momentum thickness, it has the dimension of length also as well. I would like you to notice that theta is the smallest, delta star is larger, delta is the largest of them all. Another example, flow through a reducing pipe bend in a vertical plane. We had this before in a horizontal plane, but this case is a vertical plane. I mean, point two is higher vertically than point one. Accordingly, when we apply here Bernoulli equation, we consider the potential energy at two is larger than the potential energy at one. When we apply the momentum equation in direction of Z, we take the weight of this fluid into consideration, the weight of this fluid into consideration, okay? Again, here the mass conservation, A1 V1 equal A2 V2, and we apply Bernoulli equation to get any missing data, like for example, if Z2 is given, but P2 is not given, you can get the value of the pressure at exit by using Bernoulli equation. The momentum equation, as you can see, P1 A1 minus P2 A2 cosine theta plus Fx, all these are external forces. They come on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, we have minus O A1 V1 squared, mass minus O A1 V1, and the momentum you multiply by V again, 1. At exit, we have O A2 V2, mass flow rate leaving, with a component in x direction, V2 cosine theta. Again here, we have component in the z direction, V2 sine theta. Okay, V2 sine. And here the pressure. The pressure at inlet has no component in direction 1 or in potential 1. Okay. We get the resultant force. Again, I would like to give an example for power to be extracted by a wind turbine. The wind turbine converts kinetic power from the wind into mechanical power, and then usually to the generator and get electric power as well. The average speed at the site of the turbine is 9 meters per second, which is V1. Before you put the turbine, it's V1. And then I would like to use the perfect gas relation to get the density of the air. You have a pressure and temperature, and using perfect gas relation, you can get the density here. Now, for maximum power, V4 would be 1/3 of V1. V4 would be 1/3 of V1. So since V1 is 9, we use for maximum power, maximum CP, power coefficient, V4 is 3 meters per second. Okay, the power extracted equal the kinetic power in minus the kinetic power out. And you can substitute here to get also the density from perfect gas relation and the area pi d squared over 4. And V2 is equal V1 plus V4 divided by 2. You get the power extracted. You can also apply the momentum equation to get the force, axial thrust on the fluid, and then the opposite will be on the turbine. Notice that this power is a maximum that can be obtained because CP for this case is 0.593, which is a Pitts limit. The power extracted divided by the power in a thin tube of velocity V1 and area equal to the swept area of the turbine, pi d squared over 4, which is A2 or A3. Now you can get the thrust the same way here to be 3,280 newton. God willing, I will see you on Tuesday in the problem session. We'll try to arrange for laboratory as well. God willing, if you have any question or a problem that to be solved, please come and see me at my office or at the problem session, God willing, on Tuesday. I wish you every success and God be with you all. Samir.